can tell you this, Philly's going to be the lead. Philly's going to be the vanguard of what's happening with open data, because that's where Philly is right now. We know there'll be more city data. I haven't officially started this in GTA Office, but I can say this with some confidence because I can read the executive order that the mayor signed. It clearly calls for more data from city. So we know there'll be more data coming. We know there'll be more APIs because, as I just said, I think that there's a real strong awareness now among institutions that have lots of location data that they don't want this, they want through an API. Developers are used to using APIs, so let's give them the information that way. I think what you'll see, especially given the strength of Philadelphia packing to the community, you'll see more outreach to developers. You'll see more community building, which would be really, really cool. Having see city employees or city sanctioned developer events would be super cool, right? You're also going to see more intercity cooperation. You're going to see cities cooperating with each other. Now, I'll show you one last thing. This is brand new from data.gov that has these communities that they put together. And they bring like minded data consumers together in communities. This one is called cities.data.gov. And it is actually a collection of data from multiple cities. One place. I think right now it has the city of San Francisco, Chicago, New York, let's say Baltimore, maybe? These are the Chicago city. But what we're going to actually see is we're going to see, Seattle, San Francisco, New York, Chicago. So, bringing these data sets together from different cities and putting them in place. The next step you're going to see is you're going to see standards for this data. You're going to see cities starting to share standards and say, hey, you know what? It's great that our crime information is out there for people to use, and so is your cities. But it would be a lot easier for people to use if the format for that kind of data matched the format of your company. I actually had a really interesting discussion recently about restaurant inspection data. And it was sort of a real eye-opener for me because it was a consortium of representatives from big cities. And we were really close to being agreeing on our shared standards for restaurant inspection data, which I think really cool. Except we came down to the grade. And it turns out that one city, a large city on the Northeast, a really large city on the Northeast, is very, very tied, very invested in this grading system that's from 0 to 1. That's the wrong person. Sorry, that's the other person. This city has actually a letter grade, A to F. They're very, very invested in that. Another city had the 0 to 100. A big city in the center of the country that's all awake. this notion of an additional piece of information about the risk factor for that restaurant. And all these cities were very, very invested in their own format. So it was really interesting that the meat of the discussion around creating this intercity standard that would blow the doors open for the app development for some of this stuff, centered around the grade, you know, what we were going to actually, how we were going to say whether restaurants were doing well or not doing well. Totally non-technical discussion. It had nothing to do with technology or how the API was built or not, anything like that. But so that's the challenge. But I do think we're going to get there soon. I think the fact that we have now amalgamated all this data in place, and more cities are going to be added to this, tells us that we're heading in that direction. So that's the future.